It's that time of the month again. Yes, once again, it's time for another Box Office Monthly. Now, if you're unaware of the show, allow me to explain. It's basically where I predict which movies of each month I think are going to be the biggest hits, the biggest surprise, and biggest flops of each month, and see if I got my predictions right. If you are still unclear about how the show works, I highly recommend that you go check out my August video, which was coincidentally the first video I did of this series. But as the rest of you who keep continuing to watch this show, by the way, thank you for that, let's get right on into it. Now, my predictions for November were that the biggest hit would be Frozen 2, the biggest surprise would be Knives Out, and the biggest flop would be Terminator Dark Fate. And as usual, I got 2 out of the 3 predictions right. Still not bad, but I would still like a good 3 out of 3 win, but hey, what are you gonna do? Obviously, the biggest hit of the month was Frozen 2. Easy win. If you didn't get this right, there's something wrong with you. This movie in America has earned a total of $332 million, and it's making all sorts of money around the world. It helped Disney cross the $10 billion mark, which is insane. Scary, but insanely good. That's props to them. What an achievement. This also has the highest opening for an animated film of the year. It beat Toy Story 4's record opening with $120 million, where this opened to $135 million, which is absolutely astonishing, which I know a lot of people are indifferent about this movie. Some people downright didn't like it, but as for me, who really liked this movie, I am super happy about this. It's making a ton of money. I'm glad a lot of people are seeing this, and it's making the money it deserves. As for everyone, sorry that you didn't like it, but at least it keeps the studio and people their jobs. Am I right? As for biggest surprise, which I also got right, mind you, we have Knives Out, which is also, coincidentally, another movie I really liked. I am really happy to see it make a ton of money. This opened to a 5-day opening of $40 million, which, coincidentally, also is its production budget, which is extremely good. I'm so happy that this movie is making a ton of money and a lot of people are going out to see it. And it's an original film, mind you, that opened the week after Frozen 2, which is extremely good. I think this might be a big hit for Rian Johnson, maybe not as big as Star Wars or as big as a hit as the new Star Wars, but it is certainly really nice to see an original film, an original good murder mystery film, make a ton of money and having its own audience support it, which is really good. So congratulations, Rian Johnson, and the entire cast of Knives Out. You made a decent hit on your hands. Hopefully, it'll continue to flourish as the movie season is starting to get a little crowded. So hopefully, you guys will be able to keep this keep the bank numbers coming. Lastly, the biggest flop. Now, I predicted in the last video that it would be Terminator Dark Fate, but honestly, it had some staying power that I didn't honestly see coming, and I didn't keep in mind the other movie that came out this exact same weekend, and that was Arctic Dogs. Now, say what you want about Terminator, at least it had some staying power. It has some help from the international box office. It's like at $200 million internationally, which is not much, considering the high budget, but it's something. And say what you want about Charlie's Angels, but at least it didn't have the worst opening for a film in over 2,500 theaters, which is an achievement not to be celebrated. It is an extremely low number. This opened to $2 million and came in 9th, which is a disaster, especially since this movie costed $50 million, which is not saying much considering the movie we're talking about, and pretty much everyone hated it, but I didn't see it, so I don't care. Everyone who did saw it hated it, so no one cares. So congratulations, Arctic Dogs. You will be remembered for something, and it will be remembered in infamy by many. That's going to do it for this month's box office talk, but we're not quite done yet, as we still have another month ahead of us. So here is my predictions for the month of December. Now, easy win for box office hit, I'm going with Star Wars, The Rise of Skywalker. This has been tracking for an extremely high box office opening, around like $200 million, I've heard, and broke tons of Fandango records. I even heard it beat Infinity War's opening track records on Fandango, which is incredible. Not to mention the hype for Mandalorian on Disney Plus, which is all over the internet, and there's no doubt about it that this will be the biggest hit of the month. Not to mention that this is the last film of the original Star Wars franchise trilogy, which of course means there will be a lot of people waiting to see the end to the biggest franchise of all time, which once again proved that this will, no doubt about it, be the biggest hit of December. Moving on to biggest surprise, I'm going with Spies in Disguise. Those were rhymed. Now, animated movies generally do pretty well in the holiday season, with hits like Sing and Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse doing a pretty good job at the box office, earning well over their budget, and I see no reason why this wouldn't be another hit. I definitely don't think this will have like a $50 million opening weekend, especially if it comes out on Christmas Day. But I do see this becoming a potential surprise hit. I think a $30 million opening is reasonable, but I think it could end up earning more than $100 million. But we'll just have to wait and see what happens with this movie, as time will only tell. Maybe it won't turn out to be another Spider-Verse or Sing, but who knows? Maybe it might turn out to be a decent hit. And as for biggest flop, I'm going with Cats. This movie costs over $230 million. Need I say more? And that's going to do it for Box Office Talk of November 2019. What did you guys think of it? What were your predictions for November, and what are your predictions for December? Comment down below and let me know. If you like this video, like the like button. If you like this channel, hit the subscribe button. Follow me on all social media links right there. Stay tuned for my reviews of Jumanji and Spies in Disguise coming soon. And until next time, guys, stay sharp.